civilian environment. I'm going to talk about how to interface Android phone with MATLAB and Simulink, and then how to track the location of Android phone on on Google Map, and finally we are going to plot that location value on the map. So that is the flow of this presentation. So it's very simple. I have I have divided my presentation into two phases. The very first phase, I'll talk about it, how we can design a particular block diagram, for tracking the location of a device. And once we are done, we are going to talk about how we can interface Android phone with MATLAB and Simulink, and then how to deploy that particular MATLAB or Simulink model on the Android platform. So that's the flow for today's presentation. So I'm sharing my content. Hope you all can see my screen. Yeah, you can just type in the chat box. Hope my screen is visible to all of you. Yeah, but sir, can you see my screen? Am I audible?
Yes, Suraj, you are audible. You are audible, and your screen is visible.
Okay. Good. So I'll just walk out through the basic concept of the IoT, and how, what is the building block diagram of IoT, and then how we can use MATLAB for implementing IoT. So basically, we all know IoT stands for Internet of Things. So IoT is the internet working of physical devices, such as vehicle, building, and other items embedded with electronic software, sensor, actuators, and network connectivity, which enable this object to collect and exchange data. So basically, if I take an example of Android phone, so Android phone is basically a device. I can call it. I can also call it a smart device, because it consists of hardware, software, sensors, network connectivity, which is required for for placing a communication between number of Android devices. Yeah, so that's how it is. It is very simple definition, that internet working of physical devices. So talking about the building, the block diagram of Internet of Things, which are the important block in this particular block diagram. So basically, it consists of three important component, or I can say a block. A very first is edge node, data aggregator, and the software which can be used for analysis. Now talking about edge node. So edge node can be a simple connected device or a physical device, such as Android phone. Then there's a second component called data aggregator. So basically, data aggregator stands for a data store, an online data store, such as it can be your Google data store, or it can be Amazon S3, or it can be, a ThingSpeak kind of thing. So in today's presentation, I'm going to use ThingSpeak data store. So ThingSpeak is basically an open IoT platform with MATLAB analytics. It means if I'm the official MATLAB user, I'm having access to some license, then I can freely access to the IoT. I can store my data. I can exchange my data between number of devices. Some limitation is given, but yes, that is an open IoT platform with MATLAB analytics. And the third component, is an analytical software. So obviously, what this edge node does, edge node simply collects the data. Sorry, edge node simply exchanges the data between the data aggregator. So data aggregator is going to store the data. So we are going to create one channel on which we are going to store all the data, which we want to record, for example. So then, if I'm storing this much of data, then what to do with that data? Obviously, we are going to perform some data visualization, some analysis on that. For that, you need a software, right? So the software which we are using is a MATLAB software. Now, taking a very simple example. Like as I'm saying, today I'm going to track a location of Android phone on a Google Map. So it means I should have one Android application in my phone which will continuously give me a two value, latitude and longitude, right? So if I'm getting latitude and longitude value off of my Android phone, then where to store that data? If that app in my Android phone is continuously generating this result, if it is continuously generating this lat and long value, then where to store that data? So I need one data aggregator, right? So what if I try to save that data? What if I try to store that data into my laptop? It's a, you know, it's a local hard disk, right? Which has some limitation. Suppose I'm having a laptop which has a memory up to 1 TB. So it means I have a limit up to 1 TB, right? Again, that scan, you know, if I'm storing that data, then scanning that entire hard disk will really take a time. You know, it may take around 4 hours to scan the entire data, entire hard disk, and you know, go through a data set and so on. So obviously, it is a limited, you know, we have a limitation. We have so many limitations. To overcome this limitation, we talk about online data aggregator. So in this case, we are going to use ThingSpeak as an online data aggregator, where we are going to store all the data. So it means if my Android phone is working 24/7, it means 24/7 I'm recording the values on data aggregator on the channel which I'll be creating. Now suppose I have stored sufficient amount of data, yeah, and now I want to use that data for further processing. Because once you store a data, what is next task? You are going to call that data into MATLAB environment and ultimately plotting the values of lat and long on a map so that you will get the exact location of the Android. So that is a very simple flow, how these three components communicate with each other. So today, you know, we'll be talking about how we can design a model, how we can, you know, how we can build that model, deploy that model into the Android platform, and then after that, how the Android platform will store a values on data aggregator. And once data storage is done, how we can, you know, how we can visualize the result using MATLAB function. So this is a very important building block of IoT, having three main components. Like, as we all know, there are a variety of applications of IoT nowadays. It can be, you know, it can be smart cities, connected cars, smart meters, in agricultural applications, you know, like a smart agricultural, then, you know, industrial IoT and so on. So I'll not go in much detail. I would like to switch to the MATLAB environment first of all. Yeah, because we'll focus more on demonstration and less on the people. Hope my voice is clear to all of you and you can see my screen. Now, this is the MATLAB environment, a MATLAB GUI. This is a latest release of MATLAB, that is release 2020A, and it's an academic license. And you know, as per MATLAB's principle, every year they have a 2 different release. The very first release is in the month of March and second release in the month of September. So the second release will be called as R2020B. Yeah. Right now we have MATLAB and Simulink as a base platform, and on top of that we have around 100 of toolboxes with these different applications. If I want to open white paper documentation of MATLAB, I can type DOC on the command window, which will take me to the documentation. And if you see, we have these blue windows, that is MATLAB and Simulink. And rest of the toolboxes, they have bifurcated application-wise. Let's say if I want to know about data science and deep learning, that is the hottest topic nowadays. So we can perform machine learning, deep learning, you know, by using MATLAB. So we have this deep learning toolbox, like, you know, standard machine learning toolbox and so on. This white paper documentation is really helpful to learn, understand MATLAB. And you can use some basic, you know, you can use some examples, you know, to perform different type of experiments for all these domains like machine learning, deep learning, and data science, and so on. So this is the documentation. So as I said, we have to interface Android platform with a MATLAB and Simulink, right? It means we need to download some add-on packages. So if you want to interface any hardware with MATLAB and Simulink, you need to download hardware support packages. Now, if some of you are using Apple devices, yes, we do have a support packages for with Apple devices as well. So Android phone or you know the iOS phone, both can be used for this experimentation. Yeah. So from where you can download the hardware support packages. So if I go to add-ons, and when I click on this get hardware support packages, it will open a new documentation. Your machine should be connected to an internet for this. So if you want to access this add-on explorer tab, the machine should be connected to an internet. So yes, now what you need is you need MathWorks login ID and password. You should be official MATLAB user. Now, since the DYPID PIMPRI is a part of campus-wide license, so in that case, all the students and all the faculties, are the part of DYPID can get an access to the support packages Yeah, because they have the campus-wide license of MATLAB. So if you see the hardware support packages, variety of hardware support packages are available for number of hardware, including science and industry, image processing and computer vision, AI data science, signal processing, wireless communications, and so on. Now, for example, what we need today, we need MATLAB support packages or Simlink support packages for Android platform. If I just go down here, I have Simlink support packages for Android device. Since I'm not going to use MATLAB environment, a MATLAB coding environment for designing a model, I'm going to use a Simlink environment, a block-based environment for designing a model which will be deployed into the Android phone. So Simlink support packages for Android devices which you're supposed to install. So when you click on this particular package, like when you click on it a very first time, instead of manage, it will show you an install option. You're supposed to click on the install option. Once the installation is finished, you can just close this window and type DOC on the command window. And in this window, it will show you what all hardware support packages you have installed. So I've installed MATLAB support packages for Arduino hardware. That is also available with MATLAB. MATLAB support packages for IP cameras, because we can use IP cameras for AI application sort of things when you are dealing with image processing, image classification, or image recognition kind of things. Then MATLAB support for USB webcam. So if I have some USB webcam like Logitech HD camera, or if I want to use laptop inbuilt camera for image for real time image processing, so yes, you can make a use of that hardware camera as well. The Simlink support packages for Android devices. So it means I have successfully installed the Simlink support packages for Android devices. So when you click on this, it shows you some documentation like how to set up and configure, how to do some modeling, and how this Simlink model run on Android device. Along with that, it also shows you some examples. You can make a you can refer an example to learn more about how you can interface Android with Simlink platform. So that is how this documentation is really cool. Why we call it white paper documentation? Because everything is in the white box. There's nothing to hide from the user, so that user can learn everything right from scratch to the application level. So that is how we have installed. We're supposed to install the hardware support packages. After installation, what you have to do is you have to click on this add-ons option and click on manage add-ons. So manage add-ons mein kya karna hota hai? We have to interface, we have to configure your device basically. So configure karne ke baad, one Android application powered by MATLAB and Simlink will be automatically generated on your Android device. So we have the Simlink support packages for Android hardware, is it? So I'll have to click on this setup. So when I click on this setup option, a new window will be open for us. So from where we're supposed to start the configuration. Now what you need a data cable. So you'll have to connect your Android phone and, Android phone, Simlink support packages for Android devices. By mistake, and I went to some other support packages, you're supposed to click on Simlink support packages for Android device. Now at this moment, what you need to do is you need to connect connect your Android phone with your laptop using a data cable. Yeah, at very first stage, hope my voice is clear to all of you and you can see my screen. Yeah. Okay. So at initial stage, you have to install the Android Studio. If you don't have installed, then you're supposed to click on this Get Android Studio link, and you can download and install the Android Studio. And once you are done with the installation, you can click on Verify Installation, and then it will show verification successful. Click Next to Continue. Then here you have to install the Android SDK platform packages and tool. So when you install the Android Studio, and when you just in that option only, it will ask you to install some add-on packages which are required for Android interface. So there you can install this Android SDK platform packages and tool. Then when you click on verify setup, So it shows verification successful. Click next to continue, and you can go next. At this point, what you have to do is you have to open setting app in your phone, and in that app you have to go to the system option, like that is about system option or about device option, and there you will find one build number. So in that, on that build number, you're supposed to click on multiple times and until you get the message that developer mode has been enabled. When you click on this option, your phone will be in a developer mode. It will continuously pop up one message on your notification window that the phone is working into the developer mode. Then you click on next, and then you have to go on that developer option mode. So one new option will be open for you, and in that you have to just turn on this USB debugging option. So when you turn on the USB debugging option, it means now I can easily deploy any Symbolink model on the Android platform. Then go next. Now which type of phone you are using? Am I using a Samsung device, a Google device, or different device? Yes, I'm using a different device, because in my case I'm using a Vivo phone, so I'm gonna say a different device. And then yes, I have installed the appropriate Android device driver on this computer. If you haven't installed, you have to click on this link to get it installed. The next, now here it is asking you to allow USB debug and so on, but this process we have already done. We have connected the Android device to the laptop using a USB key. Then go next. Just give me a moment, I get my data table. Yeah, sorry for the pause. Yeah, so I've connected my phone with this laptop using a data cable. So the next stage is, refresh your refresh the option so that you can find your phone. So let me just go back to the, okay, I have to first of all go to the setting option in my phone, then I'll just go to the about phone option, and I'll open that developer mode. So I'm enabling developer mode option in my phone. So if I show you, it shows. It shows this red color, the pop-up button. It means it is in developer mode right now, if you can see. Yeah. So after that, I'll go next, different device. I've installed the packages. And here it shows which phone I'm using right now. So it shows the phone. Yeah, then going next. Now what you have to do is you have to basically connect your laptop and your Android phone to the same Wi-Fi infrastructure. So it should be connected, like both the devices should be connected to the same Wi-Fi infrastructure for successful interfacing in this tool. So you'll click on the next option. And now a verification has been divided into three different processes. The very first is build app, then run app. So build app and run app, at this stage, what will happen? It will generate one test app into your Android phone. And finally, it will test the connection. So testing connection means, is your phone compatible for deploying Symbolink models or not? If that test connection is successful, it means, yes, you can easily go for deployment. So that's the process we're supposed to follow now. So I click on install taste app. So it may take a time around 30 to 40 seconds to get it done. So this configuration is very important. So we'll have to first of all verify the configuration of Android device for MATLAB or Simulink. Now hardware support packages for both the platform, that is MATLAB and Simulink as well, are different. So if you want to work in MATLAB environment, you're supposed to install MATLAB support packages for Android devices. And if you want to work in Simulink platform, you're supposed to install the Simulink support packages for Android devices. So I'll show you on the I'll show you on screen once I get a taste app generated in my phone. So once this configuration is complete, we'll go to Simulink for designing a model. So we will need some block like Android sensors at the input and then ThingSpeak block at the output, because when a deployment will be done, the app which we are going to deploy in my Android phone, that app will write a data on ThingSpeak channel. So for that, we'll have to use ThingSpeak block at the output and Android sensor block at the input. Okay, by that time, I'll just take you to the ThingSpeak. Hope you all can see my screen. So ThingSpeak is the website, ThingSpeak.com, which is an open IoT platform with MATLAB Analytics. So if you see ThingSpeak for IoT project, data collection in the cloud with advanced data analysis using MATLAB. Okay, so I've got taste app created in my Android phone. So build app and run app is completed. And if I show you on the video on the screen, so this is the app which I have created. Can you see that? Yeah. So this app is basically powered by MATLAB and Simulink, and it is asking me to basically share my cameras and all these devices to get it done. I request all the participants to mute yourself. So the first notification you get is allow test app to take pictures and record videos. So which I need to allow. So I'm saying allow. And after that, the next notification you get on your screen is allow test app to access photos, media, and files on your device. It is like similar other application. After that, test app will be done. Now you have to test connection. So you'll have to click on verify installation. So when you get test connection with a green tick, then you can consider that the configuration is done. Yes, so next. So the configuration is done. So the hardware setup process for Android is complete. And if you want to see the example, you can just open that. I don't want to see the example because I have already seen it. So I'll just click on finish button. It's done. So setting is done. Now we have to, I'll just take you through the ThingSpeak. Then we'll switch to Simulink environment. Yeah. So this is the open IoT platform for MATLAB Analytics. So there are different applications of ThingSpeak, like ThingSpeak for students and educators, ThingSpeak for air quality monitoring, ThingSpeak for energy monitoring, or ThingSpeak for smart farm. Like there are so many applications and documentation is given on this website. You can make use of that. So I have already logged in. So I can just click on channels and my channels. So it means I have created a channel for different application. So I have created three channels basically: GPS track, upload weather data from a public channel, and Android data load. So if you want to create a channel, you'll have to click on new channel here. In that, we'll provide a channel name such as agri data, for example. And you'll have to feed in other values like channel description. How many parameter you are going to store. So in my application, I need only two, that is latitude and longitude. So otherwise, it depends on the application. As of now, with this free access or open access of ThingSpec, total 8 fields are provided. And once you do that, you can just click on the save channel options, and the channel will be created for you. So when you create, when it creates a channel, it will also assign one unique channel ID to your channel. Now suppose this is the channel which on which I have shared my data, I have stored my data. So I'll just open that for you. So GPS track is the channel name, which was updated on 20. Like date and time, everything is given on this. So channel ID is 285615. It will find the location of connected device, author, access is public. Public means that anyone can see my data, anyone can download my data if it is required, or if it is fine, useful to you. If you see MATLAB analysis and MATLAB visualization, two options are given. It means you can write your code online, so that MATLAB window is given, where you can write your code and you can execute your code as well. So within this ThingSpec environment, you can access to MATLAB online MATLAB environment as well. And you can also do a data visualization by using different kinds of MATLAB function like plot, stream, scatter, bar, and so on. So this is the private view. If you can see, field 1, field 2. Field 1 is latitude and field 2 is a longitude. And the date is Monday, June 22nd, 2020. Today it was updated at 10:52:34. And this is the public view. So it will look the same, but few options will be minus like this. After that, if you want to do a channel setting, like for example, as of now, I have only two fields. If you want to add more than two, then you can do that. That setting can be done. Then sharing. So sharing means keeping a channel view with channel view private. That is only up to you. Share with everyone that is publicly or publicly available, or share channel view only with the following users. Like it means you can add the email IDs and share the access of this channel to those email IDs. And then API key. So API key is quite important. So API key is used for write operation and read operation. For example, if I want to write a data from my Android phone to ThingSpec channel, I need to use a write API key. And if I want to read a data from ThingSpec into Android phone, I need a read API key. That is the permission that we're supposed to provide. Then the last option is data import and export, where you can upload your data if you want to store it for, if you want to store it for further usage. And you can also download a data, like whatever data points you have stored till the date. As of now, on this channel, I have stored total 308. I have done total 3,084 entries. So this is about ThingSpec, and this is our data store, online data store, which we have used as a very important component building block. And now we will go to ThingSpec now. We'll go to Simulink, because we have done with the configuration, we have done with the ThingSpec, with channel creation and channel configurations and so on. We have got the API key. Now, very important thing is we have to create a model which will be deployable to Android platform. So I'm just going to open one create model, a blank model for us, so that we can get a component and we can get the model ready, so that it will be deployed into the Android phone. So I'm using a computer with 8 GB of RAM. So still, if I'm trying to run a high-end application, which required a complex which has a complex processes, which need a more simulation time. So what happened when you install hardware support packages, all the required blocks for designing those models will be automatically updated into the library browser. So right now we have installed Simulink hardware support packages for Android device, right? So when I click on library browser, so I just show you how this block gets automatically updated. So this sibling support packages for Android device will be automatically updated. You can see we have got this advanced audio video communication sensors and user interface. So if I click on sensors, it consists of Android, you know, it consists of location sensor, it consists of gyroscope, humidity sensor, light sensor, orientations, pressure sensors, and so on. Yeah. So if I what we need a location sensor at the input. So I'm adding that block to model entitled, and I need for user for communication. So whom I need to communicate with? ThingSpeaker, right? So for that, I'm gonna access a block from communication. So I need to use ThingSpeak, right? Because I'm gonna do a write operation on ThingSpeak channel. So add block to model entitled, and I'm gonna close this. So once that block gets added to this canvas, we are good to go with design. So like this, if you see. So if I double click on this ThingSpeak write block, we have to mention channel ID, the number of field, total we have total 2 field. Update interval we are gonna keep 15 seconds, because with open version of IoT, you know, ThingSpeak, the by default update interval is 15 seconds. But when you buy a ThingSpeak platform, the update interval is only 1 second. Then you're supposed to enter the value of API key, so which I'll get from here. So write API key. And apply, and OK. And then to make it, you know, to make the signal more filter, you can add FIR filtering in between this. So I just open one diagram where I have done this design. So just give me a moment, I'll open that model. So yeah. So I have Android sensor at the input, and then this block, and I'm just doing I'm using a FIR filter along with, you know, if you want to see the variable, you know, the block diagram name, you just can select all of them and like this, you can see. So this is the block diagram which we are using for deployment. So that we get one app into the Android phone. Now, if you see what is the design, what is the model name? GPS location. So with the same name, it will create one Android app into my phone. So now, when we are done with the designing of model, you have to go to this app section, and in that app section, you'll have to click on run on hardware board. So where we'll select which hardware we are gonna use. So now by default, this hardware tab is open, but otherwise this hardware tab will be open for you. Yeah, when you select that run on hardware apps, the hardware tab will be open for you. Then you have to select which hardware board you are using. And after that, you'll have to, you know, just click on, the deployment option. Now there are two options given. The one option is run on a hardware. This is called an external mode. So in this external mode, what happens, it will not deploy the Simulink model on Android platform. It will only run this Simulink model on the Android platform into an external mode. That is not a permanent deployment. So this, most of the time, this monitor and tune option is used to tune the design, so that it will achieve the expected result. And the permanent deployment option is basically this. So build, deploy, and start. So when I click on this build, deploy, and start, it will actually start a deployment process where embedded coder toolbox will come in picture. So what embedded coder does? So embedded coder basically converts your, Simulink model into the optimized C++ code that will be understood by the Android platform, the embedded platform. So when I click on this build, deploy and start option, it will start a deployment process and it will also give you a code generation report. So since I have already deployed that model in my Android phone, so I'll not go, I'll not go for deployment. But this is the option to, you know, to deploy your Simulink model on the Android platform. Yeah. Now again, if you see, there are two options: build only and build deploy and start. So build option is only for code generation, and build deploy and start option is for generation of code, that is generation of C and C++ code, that deployment into the Android phone, and start will automatically start that particular Android app on that platform. So if I click on this build option, let's see the code, how it generates a code and how it gives you a code generation report. So it's in the process right now of building a model. So if you see, you can just focus on this message, which is initializing right now. It is initializing the building process. Yeah, so it has some you know, some previously generated files. So I just want to remove and continue. So if you see my current folder, you can see some GPS location ERT. ERT is embedded real time, you know, real time workshop. So RTW is the earlier name of embedded coder. So they have done this particular coding by using embedded coder too. So it, you know, that model want to remove those file and make make a new file for a code. So if you see, there's the option called building right now. So it's building the design. So it's evaluating a block parameter. Then, you know, there are number of stages which that model is supposed to go through. Completing post-propagation task, it started. So once this compiling is done, we'll get the code report generated. So once we are you know, see the code generation report, then you can go for, you know, so normally what you can do is, instead of build, you can click on the option build, deploy and start, so that it will give you a deployment, a complete deployment into the Android platform. You can see the app is generated in your Android platform. So when you will run that app will, you know, that app will log a data on Thingspeak environment on a particular channel, because we have also mentioned the channel number. If you see, we have mentioned the channel number, we have also mentioned the API key. Yeah, so it, you know, it's a long process, so that's why it's, you know, it takes time. Hope all can see my screen and I'm audible. So once this is done, we can see the code generation report. I want to show you how it generates a code. So we need basically embedded coder toolbox. So embedded coder is basically help you out in generating optimized C, C++ code out of your MATLAB function or a Simulink model. So in this case, you are not going to write a single line of C code. You know, it gives you auto code generation. So most of the industries who are working into model-based design, they rely on auto code generation. using this toolbox is like MATLAB coder, Jupyter coder. Even we do have a HDL coder basically. So HDL coder, what HDL coder does? HDL coder converts your MATLAB or Simulink programs into Verilog and the HDL code. And then it also, you know, it also make possible, you know, code simulation with the Xilinx platform. So once this building is done, we will go for ThingSpeak part. Okay, so what I'll do, let it be, you know, in that process. So since I have already deployed app, I would like to take you through the app only. So I have app created in my Android phone with the same name called GPS location. So I just turn on my camera so that we can go through it. And after this, I'll show you the code report generated. So if you see in my phone, just like, okay. Can you see a GPU? Okay, because it's a mirror image, you can see, but this is the MATLAB apps which I have. I have human detection, app, I have GPS location app, and I have some other app called NAT. So if I open this particular GPS location app, you would see, you would see some scope kind of thing. Yeah, can you see a scope kind of thing? And you know, there are two options basically. One is a scope, and second is a data logging. Second is the info. So this app is basically made up of Simulink, and the third option is logging the information. So you know, this one means that one indicates it has logged one value of latitude and longitude at this moment from this app where on ThingSpeak. Likewise, you know, if my app is continuously open, it will keep writing the values on the valid on the ThingSpeak device. So that's how this app basically works. And if I open, this is a graph, you know, where it try to show the value. So this app which we have created automatically by using a Simulink. So this is called a deployment. So when you deploy the model, that's how you get the app created in your Android phone. So now let's go to ThingSpeak. Channels, my channels. Okay, this is ready. I need to see the code generation report. Okay, I'll show you later on. Yeah. So GPS track. Right now, my app is open in my phone, and if I go to the private view, you can see the values are updated. It is on Monday, 22nd June. At this point of time, that is, if you see, the last value was 244, yeah, and on this side as well 244. So we have got the value. So it means this app is continuously updating our data on ThingSpeak. Now in next stage, what we have to do is we have to read this value back in MATLAB environment, and we're supposed to plot those values where on ThingSpeak on the Google Map platform. So I'll just go to what
Suraj, your screen is not visible now. Can you please present it again?
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Can you please mute the other participants?
Yes.
Yep. Okay. You could see now that Android demo.
I guess.
Sorry, I'm not like you're not audible.
No, actually, we are not able to see. We are able to see only the Explorer.
Yeah, but before that, I have shown that Android demonstration. Yes. That you could see.
No, we had missed you after. After the apps which you installed on your phone. Can you start after that?
Yeah. So the app I have already displayed, right? So after that app, what I was trying to show you, now that app is continuously writing a values on the ThinkSpeak channel. And if you see, this is my channel and this is the private view. So when I go to this latitude and longitude, this data is updated. So it is showing a time that is 246, 247 like that. And it is showing date. So it means now this app is writing a values. It is updating a values on a ThinkSpeak channel. So that's how we are getting this updated data. Now it means if you just recall that IoT block tag.
One second, sir.
Yes.
Yes, your screen is not.
I have yes, now it is. Already. Let me present one more time. Entire screen.
I request other participant not to share your screen. It is creating disturbance.
Okay. Okay, sir. Can you see it now? Can you see my screen?
Yes, yes. You can go ahead. Okay. Yes, we are able to see your screen.
Okay. So what we have done till here? So we are able to successfully deploy the GPS location app into the Android platform. And now that app is, app is successfully writing the lat and long values on data aggregator channel. Now we have done this part. Now what we have to do is whatever data we have aggregated till now, we will read that data into MATLAB environment and will plot those values of lat and long where on Google Map. So that's, so now we are going to focus on this particular chain. Yeah. So we'll switch back to MATLAB environment. Yeah. So a very simple code I have written for this. Just let me open for you. So again, we need to mention the channel ID. So right now, we are going to read a data from ThinkSpeak into MATLAB. So we're supposed to use a ThinkSpeak read function. So here, if you see in the code, just let me go to homes preferences. I just raise the font size by one. Okay. So we have format long. So basically, what is the use of format long? So by default, if I type anything in MATLAB, it considers four decimal places. And if I type a format long and then a pi value, it considers a huge stream of digits, all the decimal points. So, the lat and long values are always present in such format. I don't want to even miss out a single bit, because I don't want to compromise with the location value, because I need to plot an exact and accurate location on the map. So I'm considering a format long and wave map. What wave map basically does, you need a mapping toolbox to open WebMap into MATLAB environment. So mapping toolbox is a separate separate module available with MATLAB. So what WebMap does, WebMap will open the world map for you into MATLAB environment. So right now I have executed this WebMap statement and MATLAB is busy opening world map. So after that, I'm going to use a while loop because I don't have fixed range to define. So because if this process is 24/7, then my app should continuously write a data on channel. And then my MATLAB should continuously read a data from channel into MATLAB environment, and it should plot that particular location value on a map. So like this, this is a world map which we have opened with the help of mapping toolbox. And after that, a while one, I'm using a function called ThinkSpeak read. So in that InfiKit, I'm providing the channel ID from which you're supposed to take the data. Then fields is a parameter and its value is 1 and 2. So from channel, from field number 1 and field number 2, I want to read a data. So if I have more than two fields, for example, so you can randomly, you can randomly select the field. There's no limitation to go serial. The number of point 1, because there should be one pointer on the map showing indicating the location. And then obviously we normally what we to plot a 2D data, we use plot and stream option, right? But when you want to plot something on map, something on world map, you have to use this world map marker. So WM marker, in that I'm providing data 1, data 2. So basically when I execute this statement, CH info will consist of channel ID, and this data will consist of latitude and longitude. So it will be a, it will be a 2 by 1 ka vector, a column vector. So that's why data of 1, data of 2. Feature name is Suraj Gawande, because that's the location label I want to provide. And color will be a random. It will be a random combination of R, G, and B. And pause after 12 seconds. So I'm just using a pause of 12 seconds so that I'll give some time to my Android phone and that TensorFlow to update the new data. So every after 12 seconds, it will try to update the new value. So that is how I have done the arrangement. You can change this value accordingly as per your analysis and simulation. And when I execute this data, of course, my machine is connected to an internet so that it will go online on ThinkSpeak server, read data from given channel, and plot those value of lat and long on the world map. So depending on the best internet speed, it will, it will put the values on the map. It will update the values of the map. So right now I'm in Ambega Pathar. So yes, it is showing the location, because if you see nearby, there's a Patnavati, CMU College of Engineering, and Mumbai Pune bypass, and Ambega, some other places. So yes, it has located me. And this is the correct location where I'm sitting right now. So depending on the mobile position, lat and long value, it will, it will update the value. So if you, if you want, you can just zoom in to see the more details and stuff and like that. So this is the use of world map, which make our job quite easy. So if we have lat on long value, we can easily plot those values on the world map. And now this will keep changing based on the app data, which is present on the ThinkSpeak. And now, this ThinkSpeak read function will continuously reading a value, from ThinkSpeak channel. And accordingly, it is updating the values on the web. So that is how we have, we have done this by using MATLAB, Simulink, embedded coder. We have Android support package is also important. And finally, in the end, we have used this mapping toolbox to call that particular map so that we could successfully plot this value. So that is how this is quite easy in MATLAB. Where we can build such IoT application, because MATLAB provides you hardware support packages for interfacing with different hardware, and this hardware support packages allow you to interface any hardware, be it Raspberry Pi, be it your Android phone, or be it your Arduino board, or different types of cameras along with different DSP processors. So in that case, you don't need to write a single line of code, is it? You're simply gonna convert, this coder product is simply gonna convert your MATLAB function or Simulink design into optimized C and C++ code along with a hex file. Because when you deploy, when you click on a deploy option, the embedded coder converts your Simulink model into hex file, into C, C++ and hex. And that hex file will be deployed on that particular Android platform. So that is it from my end. This is how we could do some IoT application with MATLAB. Yeah, and you can definitely go through this on this ThinkSpeak platform, which is free for all. You can create your own account. And if you're already a MATLAB user, if you have ID and password of MathWorks account, then by using the same MathWorks ID and password, you can log into ThinkSpeak. There's no need to create a separate account. Because I'm using a same ID and password to log into my MathWorks account and to log into ThinkSpeak as well. So that's it from my end. If you have any question, please type in the chat box. I would please mute yourself. Please type in the chat box if you have any queries. Good afternoon, party sir. I could read the message now. So I'm so we'll have a QA session now. If you have any questions regarding this, you just type in the chat box. And I'm also leaving my email ID here so that you can get in touch with me on my email ID. I will send you the documentation regarding this Android interfacing process. So I'll share with Abhijit sir. He'll send it to all the participants, all the important link and the process. Yeah, we can even human activity recognition can be done. By so if you have machine, so if you can deploy machine learning model on this Android platform, which is able to categorize whether the human is walking and dancing or sitting. If he's walking, then how many kilometers he has walked away. So all those stuff can be done. Yeah, Nikita ma'am, I'll send a documentation regarding this process. That how we can enter, how we download the hardware support packages, and how we can interface the Android phone with Simulink and Matlab. That configuration stages I refer to mail out to all the participants. Yes, so I'll share with Patil sir. He'll share it with all, along with the presentations and few more links.
Okay, Suraj, I guess there is no. So I really want to thank you for your wonderful presentation. I want to thank the design, entire design tech team. I guess there is one more message. Okay. So we will, I would like to thank all the participants from Dr. D.Y. Patil Institute of Technology for your participation and the support. I would like to thank Dr. S.R. Jog sir, Dr. Umira Patil madam, and Principal Dr. Pramod Patil sir, and the management of Dr. D.Y. Patil Institute of Technology for giving us chance to organize this webinar. I will be sending you the certificates on your email ID. All the documents which will be shared by Suraj, and all the process for the using the ThinkSpeak. Thank you all. We will stop here.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Suraj.
Yeah.
I request everyone to leave the meeting.